In my previous three videos, I've described three of the four ways in which you can study mathematics. If you want to become a really top student, however, you need to learn to adopt this fourth method. G'day. Welcome to Crystal Clear Mathematics, where it is easier than you think. I'm your host, Graham Henderson. Now, the first three methods, that is making summaries, practicing skills, and developing sound habits to reduce your risk of making careless errors, they will form the foundation for all of your study of mathematics. They're roughly equivalent to learning spelling and grammar and syntax in English. That's what all literature is based on, but if that's all you ever learned, you would never write novels or poetry or songs or short stories or sagas. In the same way, you can learn all the mathematical skills you like, but if you want to do mathematics really well, then you need to go exploring. You need to look for opportunities to think mathematically and to be challenged with difficult questions. Apart from natural talent, this is the big secret about what makes really top students. They actively seek out these kinds of questions and work on them. Some textbooks do contain challenge questions or challenge exercises, but if they do exist, they often take up only a very tiny part of the book. If you want to really develop your mathematical muscle, you need to seek out questions from other sources. I can recommend asking your teacher whether the school has resources that you might borrow or use or have access to. Subscribe to a student's mathematical journal if there is one in your state or your country. Ever since I was in school a long time ago, I've been subscribing to a mathematics journal called Parabola, which is specifically written for high school students, and I still enjoy reading the articles and find them stimulating. Seek out challenging competitions. Ask your teacher whether there are mathematics competitions that you can enter. Try to find books of puzzles and challenges in your local library or your school library, and be prepared to spend hours on single questions. There are lots of unsolved problems in mathematics, but it doesn't stop mathematicians from working hard at them. This is good experience. Remember what I said in an earlier video about pushing against a wall? We call these isometric exercises, and they're certainly beneficial and not a waste of time. The mere fact that you don't solve a question or a problem doesn't mean that your time's been wasted. In fact, it's some of the best study you will ever do. Now, if you actually manage to solve the problem or to discover a new principle or a theorem, the feeling of satisfaction that it gives you is hard to describe, and it's something very few students experience. I still remember, all these years later, discovering a theorem in geometry when I was about 14. The feeling was wonderful, and I remember it all these years later. It's this kind of feeling that drives mathematicians to further exploration and further study and further research. So, the fourth way in which you can study mathematics is to occasionally tackle quite difficult problems and to go exploring. The rewards are truly immense and satisfying. Now that you know the four different ways of studying mathematics, you can use this knowledge to create variety and interest for yourself when you're studying. For example, if you sat down to do some mathematics tonight and you really didn't feel like doing lots of drill work, you might consider writing out a summary of one of the chapters from your textbook, or digging out a past exam paper and going through it carefully and deciding how you might develop different habits to answer certain kinds of questions so you don't make the careless errors. Or you could even snuggle down with an interesting problem you've discovered in a book, or perhaps even one you've thought up for yourself. I've created a free PDF one-page summary of these four techniques, and it's available for you to download from a link in the description below this video. Why don't you do that and print it out? And if you're feeling a bit flat or demotivated one night, read through it and decide on using a technique that perhaps you haven't used for some time. Let me encourage you to keep checking my website as well, or perhaps even to sign up for our newsletter. I've let you in on a little bit of a secret here. As I keep adding material topic by topic to the mathematics sections of the website, I intend adding them in these four categories. That is, I'll be adding summaries, I'll be providing worksheets and drill sheets so that you can practice these skills over and over again, both on paper and in your head. I'll be providing videos that show you quite good methods and habits to develop so that you can reduce and perhaps even avoid making careless mistakes. And I'll also be providing challenge questions and puzzles for you topic by topic as well. So please keep a lookout for them, and I trust that you will enjoy them and find value in them. Please be patient with me because it's an absolutely massive task, but if you have constructive suggestions to make or perhaps even requests, then please let me know via the feedback form on the website. This is Graham Henderson, hoping that you can use this newfound understanding of these four ways to study mathematics to create variety and increase your enjoyment as you master your mathematics. Please subscribe to this channel or like or comment on this video. Thank you.